Mama period. Yeah, cool. It's great. It's wonderful. And it's an exciting time to be a woman on her period because, thank God, we have apps to track it, you know? It's great. Ladies, we all use a period tracker. Make some noise, ladies, for our period apps, you know? There's a game called Period Hunter, but that's different. That's like, uh-oh. That's like, you know, because I'm a mess. I'm so glad I have an app now because I used to have to play a game with myself once a month, every month, called like Beer Belly or Baby. You don't know. And it's like, oh, it's probably both. Gross. So I use a period tracker and it's pretty amazing because all of these apps are trying so hard to be user-friendly and over-familiar with you right now. And it just comes off as creepy. Like, Period Tracker left a bone-chilling message on my lock screen the other day. I, like, picked up my phone, and it was like, your period will be here soon. I was like, oh! Where is it? Is it outside? Like, terrified. Felt threatened. Like, I picked it up again an hour later. It's like, your period's calling from inside the house. What? No! No! Stop with these messages. It's so ridiculous. And my period tracker app, it also has like just condescending little sound effects that it makes when you're to let you know your period's arriving. It's like a fairy wand. It goes, bring, your period's here. No, no. If I developed that app, it would be like some terrible like hawk or bird of prey. And I was like, like wings flapping, like, like ring race, just terrible circling buzzard noises. Then that woman from Game of Thrones, like, the night is dark and full of terror. Your period's here. That's how I would develop that app to be a little more realistic to our struggle. Or it would be nice if it would like actually notify you that something, you know, real was about to happen to you. Like, you're about to permanently hurt your boyfriend's feelings in 5, 4, 3, 2. That's gonna be a fun noise for the recording. Does anyone ever gain a bunch of weight just to see what they're capable of? I have. I'm just competitive, you know. Everyone does, like, the freshman 15. I was like, freshman 50, bitches. Because I like to be the best. Thank you. They say if you want to lose weight, you're just supposed to keep a food journal. I don't know. I tried it. And, you know, I don't know what happens. You write down everything you eat. You don't lie. You're just very honest. And then I guess you do this for a month. And then I guess you show it to a doctor, and they're like, yep, you're a fat fuck. Like, I don't know. I don't know what the end part was. I never got to that part. But I wrote in my journal. And I learned a lot about myself, and I was writing down all my meals while I was doing this. And first entry would be like a delicious, balanced, healthy breakfast. I was like, I'm good at eating. Yeah, I am. Lunch would be wonderful, just enough calories. I was like, killing it. But then every night, at the bottom of the page of my food journal, there'd be like an entry scrawled in like a stranger's handwriting at 1 a.m. Like, 5 martinis and 3 burritos. Fuck you, Brooke. Good luck. Oh, okay. It's unnerving to receive hate mail from yourself every morning. And I was like, okay, this isn't a food journal so much as it is a very sad diary written in salsa. And I love that sort of sentiment now, too. Like, there are a lot of positive ads out there. They're like, our bodies tell a story. And I'm like, that's wonderful and empowering. But, like, can we agree that sometimes that story is like, she ate the fuck out of some food? Which is fine, because I did. It's the truth. I love food. Eat food. I don't give a shit. The worst thing you can do is eat, like, gross diet food. I had, like, a weird, shameful moment where I was feeling bad about myself. And I ate, oh, I'm so embarrassed. I bought a Bethany Frankel Skinny Girl candy bar. Oh, God, I'm sorry. And I immediately was like, oh, God, I'm so ashamed. It feels like fire. I hate it. Like, get it out of my hand. And I went, like, into a bathroom to go shame eat it. And I, like, took the wrapper off, like, the Skinny Girl candy bar, and it was actually just empty and had a note inside that said, try harder, bitch. And I was like, oh, you are so right, Bethany. Good message. I love it. I don't know if you guys do this. I do this thing.